Well, trees give us enormous amounts of joy. They give us shade, they give us wood for furniture, for building houses, ships, doors, windows. Trees give us so much. They give us fruits, and we seldom acknowledge the contribution of trees. Now, we are sitting under a huge banyan tree. And banyan is very interesting. How did the name banyan came about? Now, India has a very hierarchical caste structure. There are the Brahmins, the Kshatriyas, the Banyas, and the Sudras. Now, when the Britishers came to India, they found that a lot of merchants had spread their wares under a very shady tree. And when they asked people, what was this tree? And they said, who are these people? And the people said, they were told that these are the Banyas. And because it was a banyan tree, hence the banyan derives its name from the Banya caste. Now, this etymology of trees is very, very interesting. And I have with me two leaves of the banyan tree. And with trees, not only do you get houses and wood and shade and fruits, but you can also make very lovely toys. And this is a very small example. Take this leaf, and I'm just going to make two slant cuts and remove the top part. So this is one part. It looks almost like the face of a cat. And the other one, I'm going to cut along the midrib. Just tear this along the midrib. And if I put both these parts together, well, it gives you a profile of a cat. So that's a toy in a jiffy. While going for a walk, you can also make toys. We'll see more possibilities of what kind of toys you can make with trees. Now you can see this creeper. It has grown over a banyan tree and is overhanging. And you can see the brown fruits, which are winged fruits. And they almost look like as if they are made of brown paper. And well, when they dry, they fall down. Now you can see several of these fruits are lying on the ground. And if you pick them up and you examine them, you find that they're like turbine blades, with four blades on this turbine. And if I just blow a little bit, they fly off. And now, if I were to poke a needle inside them and hold the needle as the axle and blow in the middle, then this whole turbine will spin very fast. And this is exactly what we have done in this toy. If you put a wire through this and bend the wire at right angles twice and attach it to a straw with tape. And if I just blow through the straw, air is going to strike the veins. And this winged fruit will spin round and round just like a turbine. Well, to make this toy, you need cello tape, a stiff straw, needle, etc. Now, this is the winged fruit with four blades, and it looks almost like a turbine. Take a piece of wire, and there is a natural hole in the winged fruit. Weave through it. The right hand loop prevents the fruit from falling off. And the fruit must rotate freely on the wire. Then bend the wire at right angles twice over. You can see two bends and tape it to the strip straw. You'd be blowing through the strip straw and the breeze will strike the four veins of the winged fruit. This is the final toy. Now here is a winged fruit of a creeper. Now, nature has made fruit with wings so that these seeds can fly and disperse far and wide. This is nature's way of propagating itself. Now, this is a winged fruit. You can see there are four flutes. It's like a turbine with four blades. And if you just weave a wire inside this, this small piece can... And if you attach a straw to this, and I blow through the straw, then the air strikes the four blades and this winged fruit goes round and round just like a turbine. It's an extremely joyous, dynamic toy which costs no money at all. I hope you enjoyed this toy made from a wind flute. And if you look around in nature close by, in your vicinity you will find similar plants. And look carefully and pen down as to how do they disperse their seeds. Write your feedback or comments at support@arvindguptatoys.com, or you can even send an entry on our Facebook or YouTube page. Thank you.